Dear students, today we will talk about design phase. So in previous module, we have discussed about software development lifecycle and we have covered the first module of requirement analysis phase. So today we are focusing on design. So basically in requirement analysis, we have identified the problems. And in design, you are going to propose a solution. It is just a proposal. It is not going to be implemented. And this would be implemented in the implementation phase, in the next phase. So you can simply say that when you are going to build commercial market or commercial building, so the requirement is to build such a building and solution would be your design documents, your detailed specification, your structural designs, and your other kind of electrical designs, your piping designs, all of those things are actually the design documents. And then that building will be implemented, will be actually built based on that design. So similarly here in software systems, we want to design all of the requirements. We want to make a proper design for all of the requirements, which will be then used for the actual implementation. So in requirement analysis versus design, so we have learned that requirement analysis provides a description of the proposed software. However, design involves creating a plan for the construction of the proposed system. And RA identifies the problem. However, design finds the solution. And requirement analysis decide what a system will do. And design will tell you that how the system will achieve this problem, will achieve the solution of this problem. So the design outcome is basically the internal structure of software system. So you may say that this system has so many of modules. For example, if we are going to make a software for virtual university, so that different modules can be built and linked together. So for example, you can say one of the module is the admission system, one of the module is the registration system, one of the module is students examination system. So all of these internal details and how this will be built, what are the internal structures, what are the data structures you will use. So all of such details, what kind of variables will you use? What would be their ranges? So all of these things which we have discussed, I'm trying to link up all of these things that you need to give very detailed specification. And this detailed description of the software system structure that can be converted into programs. So after the design, you just need to give that design to a programmer who is not normally very experienced programmer. So that programmer just need to follow the design and the software will be ready. So if the design is not proper, then there could be number of ambiguities. Even if you hire a very experienced programmer, so your software might have different problems. So we have discussed office building example. So in that case, we have structure plans, making design that can be converted into programs. So it is basically the blueprints describing the proposed building of various levels of details. And in software design, notational system and many modeling and diagrammatical methodologies and different diagrams are used to design the softwares, which you will be studying in software engineering course. And here we summarize our module. We have discussed requirement analysis and the difference between requirement analysis and design. Then we focused on software design and we have discussed that what are the outcome of design document, and we have also discussed the similarities between building design and software design.